Check. I will do a check. You guys hear me? Wi-Fi might be a problem. See if we can open it. Alright, let me check on my phone if I can hear myself. One, two, three. Check.
1, 2, 3.
Alright, looks good. Hey everyone. So, today I got my new coma. And it's basically an autopilot system which can be plugged into pretty much any recent vehicle. And it basically comes with this nice package, I guess. Let's see. Yeah, so we got the unit itself, which is it's pretty much like phone, cheap phone, modified. And then... some stuff to actually hook it up to the car. So there is basically this guy which they call Giraffe, and as far as I understand, this is basically some microcontroller which plugs into diagnostic port and what looks like Ethernet cable. And there are some wires which are supposed to hook into to the stuff up here. And yeah, and USB-C cable for charging. So start the reading manual. I can pull up from that. All right, let's look around. manual reading, I guess.
Every other car I've had in the past, out of the way. This thing is
guess gotta get some plastic tool. Be right back. Alright, I got some plastic pieces. Let's see if we can pop this. Oh yeah, that's pretty easy. Got some other one here. Alright. So yeah, this is unplugged. I guess scrub this guy. So I guess this is yeah. So this goes there. This goes where it was before. Yeah, pretty easy. Now it's time to plug into OBD port. It's somewhere around. Just Ethernet. Nice. Up. Yeah, let's first make sure everything works. Power. Okay, and the power goes from this guy to that guy. Thank you. let's finish installation and cover some details. Alright, continue to set up scanning Wi-Fi networks. Okay, let's connect it to the network. Connected. Alright. Well, okay. Let's share the. I'll just turn Wi-Fi sharing. My phone. Pretty sure internet is working in the office. I don't know why it's. Okay. It's voice 5G. It's probably not. Weird. It's connected. Okay, then I need to connect to the VPA. Okay, let's try 5G. Connected. Bugs. Alright, I'm trying to share my internet zone. For some reason it's not getting an internet from the office. Okay, let's try hotspot. Thank you. connect. Yeah, continue. Choose software to install. Bashcam software, custom software. Okay, let's try custom software. It's URL. Okay. Go back. Alright. Install. It's done loading. Oh yeah, it's already installed. Read to continue. Okay, read everything. Pair your account. Load, comma, connect. Yeah, it's cleared up today. It's been pretty foggy. Yeah, it's connected, I guess. Okay, we don't have a SIM. Blah, 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 comma 2 online. Nice. Alright, successfully paired. Okay, continue. Great now, become home prime, blah, 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 blah. Alright, I guess you only get dash cam. Until you update it manually. So let's there are some regulations they don't want to break. So I think you need to download something from the website to get it fully up and running.
Okay, this will be a video on how to install the OpenPilot software on your new Comet 2. I just finished my unboxing, and now the first thing I'm going to do is plug power into it. Now I'm using the supplied USB cable that came with the kit. Okay, now we just continue our setup. The first thing it asks you is if you want to install dashcam software or the OpenPilot software. Well, we want the OpenPilot software, but first thing we're going to do is connect to Wi-Fi.
Oh yeah.
Now, I'm going to skip over this while, but and he found online that it is openpilot.comma.ai. So we put that in, hit OK, select install.
Okay.
And it is automatically downloading the software now that we're connected to Wi-Fi.
Alright.
And installing OpenPilot.
How would I set this back to it, server?
Alright, now that OpenPilot is installed, you need to read these terms and conditions. Make sure you read this if you haven't already.
Oh yeah.
There's a lot of important information here about the safety and what exactly is going on. OpenPilot does not make your vehicle autonomous. It's a level 2 system. You're still in control of the vehicle at all times. There is a lot in here that you should know. It's for your safety. So make sure you read all this.
Yeah, it went to some
Again, I've read it
recovery mode.
before on my previous install of OpenPilot. So once you get to the bottom, you accept. And here you'll pair it with your account on Comma Connect, which I can't do because I'm filming this with my phone, but you can scan the barcode. So I'll just skip for now. And now we're in the training program. So we'll hit begin training. OpenPilot is an advanced driver assistance system. A driver assistance system is not a self-driving car. This means OpenPilot is designed to work with you, not without you.
All
your
right.
attention is required to drive. I will keep my eyes on the road. I will be ready to take over at any time. I will be ready to take over at any time. Okay, OpenPilot uses multiple sensors to see the road ahead. Before any signals are sent to control your car, sensors are fused to construct a scene on the road. Camera from my device. Camera from device. A vision algorithm leverages the road-facing camera to determine the path to drive. The lane lines are drawn with varying widths to reflect the confidence in finding your lane. So it wants you to select the path to continue. Radar from your car. The stock radar in your car helps OpenPilot measure the lead car distance for longitudinal control. The indicator is drawn either red or yellow to illustrate relative speed to the lead car. So we click the chevron. OpenPilot will engage when cruise control is set. Press cruise to engage and a pedal to disengage. Engage OpenPilot. When you are ready to engage OpenPilot at a comfortable speed, locate the cruise controls on your steering wheel and press set to begin. Driver monitoring. When OpenPilot is engaged, you must always pay attention. OpenPilot monitors awareness with 3D facial recognition and pose. Distracted drivers are alerted, then disengaged from OpenPilot until corrected. OpenPilot can change lanes with your assistance. OpenPilot is not capable of checking if a lane change is safe. This is your job. OpenPilot will change lanes regardless if another vehicle is present. Start lane change. With OpenPilot engaged, turn on your signal, check your surroundings, and confirm it is safe to change lanes. Perform lane change. Continuously observe your surroundings for safety while gently nudging the steering wheel towards your desired lane. The combination of turn signal and wheel nudge will prompt OpenPilot to change lanes. OpenPilot will stop driving when a pedal is pressed. Here is where we download OpenPilot. So the web address you put in can be found online, but it is openpilot.com.ai. So we've put that in, we hit OK, select install, and it is automatically downloading the software now that we're connected to Wi-Fi. And installing
right.
OpenPilot.
Does it now. Be right back. continue. So let's continue. Blah blah blah. Okay, I need to scroll this to pair it again. And now it says successfully paired. Okay. So it has some memory. Welcome, open palette Alpha.
Alpha.
Sorry. Begin training. Open pilot, blah blah blah. I will keep, I will already ready. All that. Open pilot map. Camera phone device. Open pilot will engage when cruise control is set. Come on, there is a power. Okay. And you're ready to engage, blah blah blah. Signals will be on. So it basically will turn on with the control. On the steering wheel. Okay, I guess it's just top set, okay. Ah, okay, so. Signal, check your surrounding, blah blah blah. Sorry, turn signal. Okay, well, I guess it's all set up. Let's try to turn it on. See how it works. Key is not detected. Okay, let's grab the key. We'll play with a Sage later. Now I just want this vehicle, no GPS. But it sees the road. Okay. And it measures the speed. So let's see if we can mount it. Nice. Alright, grab some wipes and I'll clean it up and stick it. Some markers. internet is, it should probably be good for centimeters. Okay, it says calibration in progress. Okay. I have above 15. All right, let me then switch to my Spark and switch to the mobile. Switch my streaming to the hotspot. Above 15 miles per hour. All right, I can do that. Streams went down. All right, seems calibrated. So I guess nice. Oops, my camera went down. Too much fun. So going back to base, I think everything more or less works. Good comma. Nice job. Boom. Yeah, basically works. So let's see if we can get some SSH access and look what's inside. Enable SSH. Try SSH keys. Ah, okay. Ah, just by GitHub. That's pretty nice. It works. So let's see if we can figure out how to log into it. It's interesting, it already uploaded some drives. Nice. On off connection, proxy CMD. Thank you. connection closed by remote host. But at least it's... Okay, I see my mistake. Alright, well, I guess I will have to play with it a little bit more. But, yeah, really impressed. Seems to be doing what it's supposed to do, and yeah, I'll be using it while driving. So, yeah, highly recommended, guys. Yeah. Good. Thanks everyone.